The topic is posted pricing for robust crowd sensing. Due to the authors cannot come here for visa issues, so I'm presenting their works on the behalf of the leading author, my colleague, Professor Kai Han. Okay. I will try my best to present their works as clearly as possible. I also show the content of the authors here. So for some technical questions, please drop them an email. Thank you. So firstly, we would introduce the background and the motivation. The idea of mobile crowd sensing is to collect information through handheld devices such as our mobile phones. Although it has been proved to be successful in many applications, mobile crowd sensing has two key problems, including incentivation and quality control. The first problem is that the users are usually rational and selfish, and they might not prefer to join the crowd sensing. It is reasonable, right? Although the users are usually unprofessional, so the sensing data they contributed may be of low quality. The basic idea to solve these problems is to pair the users to incentivize participation and to introduce sensing redundancy such that the data readings from multiple users can be fused to increase the robustness and the quality. So actually, there are a lot of studies on incentivizing the participation in mobile crowd sensing. However, most of them adopted the sealed bidding approach, where the users report their private costs to the task owner. As then, the task owner decides the task assignment and the payment to the users. We also notice that these studies usually make use of auction mechanisms to encourage the users to become truthful. However, there are several drawbacks about sealed bidding. Firstly, people may not trust the task owner. Secondly, people may not understand the auction mechanisms at all, right? And finally, the sealed bidding approach results in heterogeneous payments to the different users, also known as price discrimination. So a better solution is post pricing, where the task owner post take it or leave it prices and the platform without sealed bidding. This is our topic today. So when the post pricing is adopted, a fundamental problem is to how to set the post price. Given the bearing knowledge of the users, if the price is set too low, of course, there would not be enough people to participate in the crowd sensing. And hence, the sensing robustness and the data quality would be very low, right? On the other hand, if we set the price too high, then the cost would be too much. Therefore, we are facing a trade-off between the cost and the quality when setting the positive price. So now I will introduce the formal formulation of the problem. So we assume that the joint distribution of the user's quality and cost, denoted as QC, are known beforehand. The task owner has a minimum quality demand, gamma, for each user and has to select a right posted price from the set of W of candidate prices. So the prices has a set of candidates. When any price WL is selected as the posted price, then the users will be classified into two groups, the good users and the bad users. A good user would join crowd sensing and behave normally, while a bad user would not join or would not behave normally. We set PRL to denote the probability that a user I would be a good user under the price WL, and hence the probability he or she to be a bad user is 1 minus PRL. So to handle the trade-off between the quality and the cost, we formulated the posted pricing for robust crowd sensing problem, PPRC for short. A proper posted price should be selected such that the number of good users would be no less than the predefined constant K with high probability, okay, the first formula. While the total expected payment should be minimized, okay? So we can see that the PPRC problem is actually a stochastic optimization problem. We now analyze the hardness of the problem. The PPRC problem is NP-hard. It proved on a reduction from the traditional partition problem. And also, the authors also show that it is nonlinear. So let SIX be the number of code users in a group X. We can see that the probability of SIX to be I is nonlinear. Further, the rule LXK denotes the probability that the number of code users is no less than K. We can see that the function rule is not submodular. Therefore, the PPRC problem is not a submodular optimization problem either. So it is a very difficult problem. So next, we will introduce our solutions. Firstly, we would investigate the submodular properties of Poisson binomial distributions, which is closely related to our solution. So recall that the key function in the PPRC problem is rho, right? And it is a tail cumulative distribution function of a Poisson binomial distribution. Although PBD has numerous applications and there have many theoretical results on it, nobody has studied the submodular properties of the PBD. So in last slide, we can show that the rule is non-submodular. However, if we consider the logarithm of rule, it becomes submodular. This is interesting. More generally, we can prove that let Y satisfy an arbitrary PBD, S and T to be the two arbitrary non-negative integers, then we can prove the distribution of this function, the known probability such that is submodular. Okay. Indeed, this is one of the major contributions of this paper. However, the proof is very tricky. We omit the details here. So given the submodular properties of the PBD, we will introduce the ironing method which enables us to transform our PPRC problem from non-submodular to a submodular problem. So recall that we have proved the logarithm of the distributing function of arbitrary PBD is submodular, which is a very nice property. However, we still have some problems left. Firstly, we can see that the rule or the known logarithm of the function rule is always negative because the rule is always smaller than one, right? And secondly, known rule has no definition if the size of x is smaller than k because rule will be zero. These problems prohibit us from using the existing submodular optimization techniques to solve our problem. So therefore, we further propose a general surrogate function for the PBD. We can see that the surrogate function is actually a piecewise function and very nice. We can prove that the function is non-negative, submodular, and well-defined for any subset of 1 to n. So now we can transform our PPRC problem into a standard submodular cover problem. We call it a submodular cover problem because it is similar to the celebrated set cover problem. However, the covering function, the function rule, is not a modular function, but a submodular function. So with all the above results, we still cannot solve the problem. Here we quote, because the reason is here, we quote the best known result for the submodular cover problem. We can see that it requires several conditions besides the submodular property in order to get a nice approximation ratio. So we need more transformations. Okay, we need, however, I should leave the details in the paper. After the transformation, we finally get the PPRC1 problem. Fortunately, we prove that either this problem is equivalent to the original problem, or the original PPRC problem can be optimally solved in polynomial time. So this is a very good result. Now we are ready to introduce the approximation algorithm. So recall that we have transformed the original non-submodular PPRC problem into a submodular PPRC1 problem. Hence, we are ready to use the existing techniques to solve our problem, which is shown in algorithm 1. For each candidate price in W, algorithm 1 first tries to find an optimal solution for PPRC1. If this cannot be reached, it will use a greedy strategy to find an approximation of solution. The final solution output by algorithm 1 is the one with the minimum cost for all candidate prices in W. So although the algorithm 1 is clear, it is actually non-implementable because we need to know the value of the optimal solution as shown in 9.8. Actually, this optimal solution, this optimal value also appears in the surrogate function we proposed. So to get a better algorithm, we further transform algorithm 1 into an equivalent algorithm 2. This algorithm first adds k minus 1 users with the smallest expected cost into the result set, such as in the 9-7. After that, the algorithm adds the users one by one. Each time, it selects a user that maximizes the ratio of its incremental contribution to its cost. So nicely, we can prove that the algorithm 2 have a logarithmic approximation ratio. So this is shown in the theorem 8 in the paper. So now we come to the simulations. So we are not aware of any other work that can study a similar problem. So we implemented three heuristics in our simulations, including greedy 1, 2, and the random algorithm. And also, we implemented the exact algorithm which output an optimal solution with exponential time. Okay, the greedy 1 algorithm selects users based on non-increasing order of their probability to be a good user. This is a very trivial and intuitive idea. The greedy 2 algorithm selects users based on non-decreasing order of users' expected costs. And the random algorithm randomly selects users. So we first study the performance of the different algorithms, is how the performance of the different algorithms is affected by the threshold theta set for the controlling the quality of the selected users. We schedule the value of theta from 0.1 to 0.9 with an increment of 0.1 in each subfigure. We can see that PPRC, our algorithm, outperforms the other algorithm dramatically. Meanwhile, the costs output by all algorithms except random increase when the theta increases. Okay, this is reasonable because the fact that more users need to be selected to satisfy the covering constraint for a larger theta. So next, we start how the size of the crowd impacts the performance. Again, it can be seen that the PPRC outperforms the others. Besides, the cost output by random greedy 1, 2, all decreases when n increases. N is the size of the crowd, which can be explained by the reason that the searching space for selecting users enlarges when the crowd size increases. So groups with smaller costs can be found to meet the quality demand. So finally, we can compare our algorithm with the optimal solution under the case of a small crowd size using 100 set data sets, okay, which where each data set contains 25 users. Because the exact algorithm can need exponential time, so we should set the size of the crowd very small, just like 25. It can be seen that the performance of PPRC is close to the optimal, right? So the red, the blank one is our algorithm, and the colored one is exact. So now let's conclude the paper. So there are several major contributions in this paper. Firstly, the authors are the first to study the cost and quality when post-processing is used to incentivize users in mobile crowd sensing. This is the first work. So secondly, the authors are the first to discover non-trivial submodular properties of Poisson binomial distributions. Okay, we believe that this discovery can be used in many other scenarios. So certainly, the author can propose a novel irony method to transform the problem from a non-submodular one to a submodular one, and propose an approximation algorithm. And finally, they give some performance evaluation by extensive simulations. Okay, so I stop here. So I'll show the contact of the author again. So if you have any technical questions, please drop them an email. Thank you.